is characterization of mineral incrustation in water supply wells and interaction with trace elements. My co-authors in this paper are Anđelka Petković and Dr. Predrag Vulić. They're a part of a greater team in Institut Jaroslav Černi. You heard a lot of papers here about importance of well clogging process understanding, and this paper is given the scientific review of incrustations in two different groundwater sources in Serbia. Well clogging process decrease well discharge capacity and increase maintenance costs, but also can affect groundwater quality. We study and research incrustation types in two different alluvial groundwater sources, Belgrade. Today you are in Belgrade. And Trnovče groundwater source in the Velika Morava alluvial aquifer. Incrustation have some remarkable properties which affect the mobility and availability of trace elements in groundwater. In this research, we focused on the several trace elements, such as arsen, lead, nickel, zinc, cadmium, and cobalt. The main goals was to determine differences between incrustation in Belgrade and Trnovce, also to determine connections between different redox conditions in groundwater, and in the end, to determine the concentration of trace elements in different type of incrustations. What was the methodology? In this slide, you see our steps to research incrustations. We analyzed 23 incrustation samples, 6 from Trnovce and 17 from Belgrade groundwater source from different sectors of Belgrade groundwater source. In first step, we use camera to inspect water wells. Then we sampling incrustations and prepare them for a different kind of analysis. In third step, we use semi-quantitative chemical analysis using energy dispersion spectroscopy and to analyze morphology of minerals in incrustation, we use scanning electron microscope. Trace elements were analyzed using ICP-OS technique. Then, for mineral characterization in each sample, we use X-ray power diffraction. After all of these steps, we got analysis data, and we divide all our samples in 4 groups. We connect them with published papers about redox conditions in those two groundwater sources. And now we are in step to give some preliminary underlayers for the modernization of well rehabilitation methods, and we will work on that step in next period also. This is Trnovce groundwater source. It's well known for rapid well clogging, and this is situation about 6 months after regeneration and rehabilitation of well BN6 and Trnovce groundwater source. In first part, you can see here you can see camera inspection, and on the another photo you see the incrustation inside suction pipe. Also on sketch, you can see the redox front in the upper part of the well screen and position of incrustation inside the well, inside the upper part of the well, and also in the zone around the tube wells in Trnovce groundwater source. In Belgrade, it's something different because we have lateral wells, about 99 lateral wells, and clogging process is not so rapid like in Trnovce. But it's also, you see camera inspection inside one of the wells from Belgrade, and we also proposed that incrustation could be found in gravel pack around the laterals. In these three pictures below, you see how it's look like after sampling. Then you see the picture from group one Trnovce groundwater source, and it's present iron and manganese oxyhydroxides. It's better. Here, you can see low crystallinity iron and manganese oxyhydroxide. In second picture, it's scanning electron image from group 2 well incrustation from Belgrade, and it presents iron oxyhydroxide, but without manganese in their chemical composition. In those four scanning electron images, you see A, B, and C is from group 3 types of well incrustations. It's different minerals of iron sulfides, and also get it. And in D are sandy wells. It's usually, we have a part of wells with a problem of sandy and concentration of SeO2 in composition is higher. Now, we try to find what mineral is in each of incrustation. We use a technique like X-ray power diffraction, and this are from Trnovce, and you see that it's low crystallinity hydroxide. Sometimes they called it amorphous. Here is from group 2. You see, get it, peaks. And this is RB48, well, from Belgrade groundwater source with bernalite, with greigit, with getit, and sulfur. It is one of the interesting wells from Belgrade groundwater source. As I mentioned, we divide all samples in four groups according to chemical composition and mineralogical composition. First group was all samples from Trnovce groundwater source because they are low crystallinity iron and manganese incrustations. I need to mention that in addition to iron, a considerable percentage of manganese was found in those incrustations, up to 28%. Second group, third and fourth, are from Belgrade groundwater source. Second group is more crystalline iron incrustations. Usually it's getit incrustations, but we must know that it's without manganese content in incrustations. In third group, we separated iron sulfide with getit minerals, and in fourth, incrustations with a large amount of SeO2 sand. Trnovce is found to be mixed toxic anoxic groundwater source, and groundwater from analyzed radial wells from Belgrade groundwater source is found to be suboxic. Professor Dimkic mentioned it in his presentations, to mildly anoxic. Trace elements concentration in groundwater from alluvial aquifers is found to be low, generally low. But depending on initial concentrations and ability to incrustated minerals to sorb anions and cations, also the time between two rehabilitations, their total concentrations in well incrustations could be elevated. This is anion concentrations. We analyze arsenate, and so it could be sorbed very well to the low medium crystallinity incrustations, especially in getit incrustation from Belgrade groundwater source. Mutual comparison present these four groups of incrustation, first from Trnovce, and concentration of lead is maximum at Trnovce groundwater source. I will explain later why. And see this third group with iron sulfide incrustations. Concentrations of zinc, cobalt, and nickel are more higher in those type of well incrustation than in group 2. The less lowest concentrations are found in group 4 because it sand SeO2 don't have a high ability to sorb sorbed trace elements. The results show that iron incrustation have a considerable affinity for trace elements. The results are consistent with those who reported in the literature that iron oxyhydroxide can sorb more anions than cations. And as I promised, lead concentrations are highest in the first group of incrustations from Trnovce because there are a lot of manganese oxide in samples, and manganese oxide could form tunnel structures and having the ability to and can sorb cations from high radii, like is lead or barium. It's usually find also barium in those types of incrustations, if you have manganese. Also, iron sulfide incrustation have high sorption capacity. Zinc concentrations was higher in group 3, iron sulfide incrustations, because zinc is halcophilic element. It was one of the reasons for that concentration in sulfidic incrustations. Cobalt and nickel also were found to be elevated in third group of incrustations. These results are consistent with the claim that iron sulfide can accommodate considerable amount of trace elements in their crystal lattice. And as I said before, smallest concentration of trace elements were found in incrustation with large amount of sand. The last slide. The amount of sorbed trace elements depends on several factors. Iron concentration in incrustation material, proportion of manganese minerals according to iron, degree of crystallinity, initial concentration of trace metals in groundwater, of course, previously sorbed trace elements, and sorption affinities. Maybe it's good to say that also depend on time between two well rehabilitation. Knowing of trace elements concentrations are very important because they are pollutants and could be potential problem for the water supply. Not in our cases, but in some other area. To choose method to disposal incrustation to landfill after mechanical rehabilitation, to know what chemical could be used for chemical rehabilitation, because after chemical treatment, some trace metal could be returned into the water or could react with chemicals. It's not good, of course. And to choose proper time for well rehabilitation, because during the process of aging of incrustation, recrystallization process, some trace elements also could be returned into the water. I found some papers that said that arsenic remediation from groundwater through co-precipitation with iron oxyhydroxide and iron sulfides could represent one of the more attractive approach because you have your own pilot in the field, and when you clean it together with iron incrustation during mechanical rehabilitation, arsenic is also removed with iron deposits. And thank you for your attention.